You hear that? That's the awkward silence of a family dinner after you just got caught vaping. Most vapes contain high levels of nicotine and disappointment. Brought to you by The Real Cost and the FDA.
This episode is brought to you by Kia's first three-row all-electric SUV, the Kia EV9. With available all-wheel drive and seating for up to 7 adults, with a 0-60 speed that thrills you 1 minute, and available reclining lounge seats that unwind you the next. Visit kia.com/EV9 to learn more. Ask your Kia dealer for availability. No system, no matter how advanced, can compensate for all driver error and or driving conditions. Always drive safely.
Listen to the 48 Hours podcast for shocking murder cases and compelling real-life dramas from one of television's most watched true crime shows. Go behind the scenes of each episode with award-winning CBS News correspondents and producers in Postmortem, a weekly deep dive. Listen to 48 Hours wherever you get your podcasts.
All right, what's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of the TMossBoss Show. And in today's episode, I wanted to talk on video games that receive overwhelmingly negative ratings. Now, I'll be more so talking on Steam, but it goes the same way for Xbox, PlayStation, and any other. Well, I feel like Xbox and PlayStation. PlayStation, I don't know. I'll have to check on there. I think they do give out ratings of games, but Xbox, I know they do for sure. But I know if I ever want to check out a game and it's on console, if the game got bad ratings on Steam, which is for PC, and my thing is this. Steam, in my opinion, like, you know, PC games, if you mess up on a PC game, what makes you think I'm going to want to buy the console version of that game? So that's why when I see video games with like an overwhelmingly negative rating, I'm like, fam, I'm not going to want to play that. Like, that's not going to make me want to play. If anything, it's going to make me curious on what the game is about. But yeah, I'm not going to play that. Now, the game that I'll be talking on, and I'll be talking on some other games, because I know there are games out there that received like very negative or overwhelmingly negative games when they started, and now they're one of the best games in the world. For an example, Cyberpunk 2077. That's a fun game. Yeah, it had its issues when it originally came out, but now they got a whole DLC out right now. It's like a separate, or it's like adding on to the story, and the DLC has an overwhelmingly positive rating. Now, that's what you overall want for your game, DLC, anything's tied to it. And if your game, if it has an overwhelmingly negative rating, in my opinion, that game is trash. That game is 100% garbage. Now, I know people may take some sort of offense to that, but my thing is this. What's wrong with your game to the point where it has an overwhelmingly negative rating? Like, I was just talking on this not too long ago when I was doing the whole calling out the gaming industry series. But no, like, that's on some real stuff. Why do you think your game has an overwhelmingly negative rating? That ain't, my thing is this, that's not just like one fan and everybody's just agreeing with that one fan. No, that's the whole community. That is everybody that is playing the game. That's why when you see video games like NBA 2K 24, for an example, that game, the only basketball game that's really out right now, what trips me out is that if I'm a developer and I want to develop a basketball game, this would be my chance and opportunity to develop something in order, you know, to get some recognition, to, you know, beat out NBA 2K24, or at least cause 2K to make a better game. But my thing is this, they know that they don't have no competition. EA ain't trying to make another NBA Live. There isn't no indie developers that wants to make a basketball video game because they don't have that license to create LeBron James or anybody else. But my thing is this, I don't want to play a game where every year it just gets worse and worse and worse. Now, I never went out and bought NBA 2K24. I'm just going based off of what I've seen people say about the game. Now, say about the game, videos I ain't seen on the game. The stuff that I've seen, it's not going to make me want to jump out and go buy it. It's not. Like, it's not nothing worth buying. And it's like, fam, it just seems like that they're only doing it for the money because they know that they're going to make money off of it. But I guarantee and I promise you, if they knew that they wasn't going to make no money off of that game and they knew that that game was going to fall under, yeah, they've been trying to do something. But they know that's the thing. They know that they ain't got no competition. They know ain't nobody going to step to them and stuff. So why should they make a good game? Why should they make an overwhelmingly positive NBA 2K? It almost seems impossible at this point. But like, no, the thing is this. When I see games like that, when I see it where they have like an overwhelmingly negative ratings, that's just like some of the stuff that crosses my mind. It's like, who's developing this game? Because if my thing is this, if I'm a video game developer, and I'm going to be comparing like being a video game developer to like an everyday job. I feel like, you know, being a video game developer, it's like one of those like jobs where you got to specialize in that type of stuff. But overall, I'm going to be comparing it to an everyday job. Now, with an everyday job, anybody can get hired on for that everyday job. Is anybody getting hired on for a video game development job? No, you have to go to school for that type of stuff. But my thing is this, if I know that it's an easy class, right, and I know that it's an easy way of getting a diploma, I ain't got to really, you know, do a whole lot, or not a diploma, but a degree, but I know I ain't got to do a whole lot, you know, to get that degree, yeah, of course I'm going to go after it. I think any college student is going to go after it, just to say that they have some sort of degree. But overall, though, my thing is this, are you passionate about developing a video game? Because I was like, it's crazy. So kind of an unrelated subject. But anyways, I went to T-Mobile today because the screen protector on my phone is peeling. So I was seeing if they can replace it. But there was a woman that was working there. And she was talking about how, like, she's a Twitch streamer and she wants to get into content creating and she wants to review, like, technology and electronics and stuff. And I could just tell, based off of that conversation, how passionate that she was about it. And, you know, that's something where it's like, you don't really see that a lot of times. Like, it's like on, like, every blue moon and on rare occasions when you see how passionate somebody is about something. But I saw that within her. I was like, oh, yeah, you definitely be good at it. You know, and that's something that I always try to let people know. It's like when you're getting into something, you gotta have passion behind it. You gotta have that drive and that motivation behind it. If you ain't got it, fam, you ain't gonna be coming out with good stuff. So that leads me to the developers 2K or whoever that's working on the NBA 2K games. My thing is this. Are you guys driven? Are you guys motivated? Are you guys passionate about coming out with another NBA 2K game? Because if not, fam, hang up the doors. Stop releasing those games. The thing is this. Even talking to the fans, I feel like I don't talk to the fans enough. But it's like, you guys really got to stop buying these games. Like, y'all got to stop posting about them. Y'all got to stop making videos about them, posting it on TikTok, YouTube, Twitch, streaming them, all that stuff. Stop supporting this company because they don't support their fan base. If they did, they have been coming out with, the thing is this, what they should be doing, and I'm going to be comparing an unrelated game to NBA 2K, but the video game that I've been playing a lot of right now is the Crew Motorfest. Now, in the Crew Motorfest, that's one thing, a feature that they have in that game where I'm like, all video games that have it where you make all this like level progression and get all these different, you know, well, in the Crew, it's a racing game, so I got all these different cars from the last Crew game that I played. I got all these different cars, and they carried that stuff over to the new Crew game, the Crew Motorfest. So I had like a Challenger, I had all these other different cars, and they had it where I can transfer that stuff over. Now, I know people, if you're not really an NBA 2K player, so let's say for an example, you get the best of the best basketball players, right? Like NBA 2K23, you get the best of the best basketball players. You then spent a good majority of your money making sure of it, that you have the ultimate team of all time. I'm saying you got prime Jordan, prime LeBron James, prime Shaq, prime Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, prime every player, Allen Iverson, I'm trying to think, Kobe Bryant. You got the primest of the primest players of all times, right? And you got literally the unstoppable, like, you play, you get built this team, you go into online lobbies, you are destroying people. I'm saying it's like, it's a blowout game. There's no way possible people are going to be able to beat your team. Now, the next NBA 2K gets announced, NBA 2K24. And you like, fam, oh, I'm about to carry over this team. And yeah, just do the stuff on there, right? And you would think with how much that game costs that you'd be able to do that. Literally, the Crew Motor Fest and NBA 2K24, they both cost the same. So you would think that you'll be able to carry that stuff over, right? Got to start all over. So all that, so like, let's say you spent like $1,500 to $2,000 making sure that you got the best of the best team, right? That just stays on that game and that game only. Versus the Crew 2, you can transfer all that stuff over to the Crew Motor Fest. Now, when I see stuff like that, and that was like my first time ever seeing it where a game had allowed me to do that stuff. So when I bought the Crew Motor Fest and I saw that that was an option, I was like, I can tell right now that I'm going to like this game. I've literally been playing the game ever since I bought it. And ever since I downloaded the demo to play that game. That's how much I have been playing that game. And my thing is this. You know, when you see, and I wasn't really a big fan of the Crew 2. I didn't really play it as much. But it's like, if I would have known that that's what that company was going to, Ubisoft and Ivory Tower, what they were going to give us. I have been supporting the Crew like crazy. You know, and it trips me out how, like, they're not like a big racing video game, but I felt like that they had a point to prove, right? That they are like, no, anybody that's going to be talking bad about this game or talk bad about our last game, we're shutting them up when this next game comes out. We're giving them a gang of cars. We're giving them just a unstoppable game, meaning like they just gonna have it where it's like you just keep playing it over and over. It's like one of those games where you're gonna be playing it for some time up until the next game comes out, because they have it set up in there where after this month, like, so all the different racing playlists that they have in there after this month, they all disappear. But it gives people, like, they give you enough time to be able to sit down and play it. And I mean, even if you're not really like sitting down and playing it that much, it's like the game is extremely rewarding. You know, like, they have it where it's your, you know, when you level up, or yeah, when you level up, you're getting like money. So it's like, if you want to go out and buy cars, you very well can do that. And it's like, comparing it to like other racing games, I'm like, fam, this is the most fun that I've had in a racing game in a long time. You know, like, this is a game that I sit down and play, not because there's not any other game out there to play. It's because I genuinely like this game. Like, it's funny because I'm, like, trying to look for other games to play, and I'm trying to, like, sit down and play other games. I find myself going right back to the Crew Motor Fest. I can't say that about NBA 2K24. I can't say that about any game out there that has an overwhelmingly negative rating. And a game, actually, that I wanted to talk on that started off with an overwhelmingly negative rating, and they worked their way up to where now they got the best DLC out right now, or just like a best like part two to the game. And it's literally like $30. It's like, and my thing is this. I have no issue with that company charging money for that DLC, because they deserve that. They deserve to make money off of this DLC. But anyways, the video game Cyberpunk 2077. Now, that game came out mad horrible when it came out. The visuals were horrible, physics was horrible, everything about that game was horrible. All right, besides the story, but for the most part, gameplay mad horrible, like last gen console. Luckily, because I remember that game, it came out the same, I think it was either the same month or same, or it might have been next month, it might have been that, like, that next month when I had got my Xbox Series X. But anyways, if I hadn't got the Xbox Series X and I went out and bought Cyberpunk 2077 on the Xbox One, fam, that game would have looked mad horrible, bruh. Minecraft has better graphics, or at least it did have better graphics than Cyberpunk 2077 did back in 2020. Because when that game originally came out, oh my god. I have never seen a game get so much hate before. And that game, actually, you know, no, I take that back. I remember when Batman Arkham Knight had came out, and that game had received some hate too, but they worked on that game. They actually sat down and they gave that game a chance to where now, let me see the ratings for Batman Arkham Knight. Batman Arkham Knight. Let's see, Steam. That game's only $20 on Steam, huh? I might have to pick that up. Yeah, recent reviews, overwhelmingly positive. All reviews, very positive. My thing is this. You know, you come out with a game, right? and it starts off bad, what do you want to usually do when a game starts off bad? You're going to want to work on that game, right? Now, talking on, because since Batman Arkham Knight was the first game that came out before Cyberpunk 2077, now I remember when that game came out, they were telling people, hey, if you want a refund for this game, it don't matter how much time you put into it, you very well can get a refund. So I feel that like stuff like that needs to start happening with companies like 2K, because it's like they're not gonna care about overall, like if they're not getting hit with no stuff like that, then they're just gonna keep doing it. They're just gonna keep putting out that bad behavior and stuff. But Batman Arkham Knight, yeah, it came out, bad ratings, people was getting their money back. And then throughout the time, they worked on that game. They fixed it. They made it better. And I remember when I sat down and I played that game, I was like, fam, this game is actually good. You know, but that was the thing, though. I played it after all the updates and after all the fixes and all that stuff. And then the amount of content that they also put into that game, it's like, you're literally Batman. and that was the same thing with I was about to say Batman 2077, but anyways, but no, with Cyberpunk 2077, it was the same exact thing. Game came out, people didn't like it. Steam offered, it don't matter how long, because they have it where it's like, you got 2 weeks and 2 hours to play a game. After them 2 weeks and 2 hours, that game is yours. You can't get your money back. So yeah, people was, they had played beyond that time, maybe because the game kept crashing or whatever, and they knew that people were going to be having issues with it, so they told people that. And so what did the developers do to Cyberpunk? They sat down, they worked on that game, and they fixed it to the point now where that game, I believe it has an overwhelmingly, the game itself has an overwhelmingly positive, or no, it's just that very positive. It's just that very positive. So it probably still some overwhelmingly, or not overwhelmingly, but just some like bad ratings here and there and stuff. My thing is this, they sat down and they worked on that game. Now, why is it that you got companies like Activision, 2K, Bungie, you got all these different developers out there where they can't sit down and work on their game? Why? Why even release the game in the first place? Like, my thing is this, with Destiny 2, I was like, that was a game that I had liked so much, and then they made the game worse. I don't get that. How is it that you're going to take away content that I paid for? That's why with Destiny, in my opinion, is a broken game. What else? NBA 2K. That don't make no sense to me, where it's like you got basketball players getting stuck on the basketball hoop. That game is a broken game. What other? Activision, Call of Duty. I can't even start up Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 unless I uninstall Steam along with all the other games I have installed. Call of Duty is broken. Why is it that you guys act like y'all can't just sit down and fix your guys' games? What's so hard about it? Because I know people are going to probably be like, oh, you don't know nothing about video game development. But yes, but I know everything that I need to know about everyday life. And if there is something broken that I need to use that's going to be making me money or whatever the situation is, I'm going to fix it. That's the thing. If it is something that I specialize in, right? Like, for an example, if I mess up on a YouTube video, if I mess up on a podcast episode, if I mess up on a stream, TikTok, it don't matter what the situation is, I'm gonna fix it because I specialize in that content. I'm not just gonna allow stuff to just keep continuing. No, I should just do that. I should just, whenever I mess up on a podcast episode, I'm gonna leave it. Video, Twitch stream, all that stuff, I'm gonna leave it. And just have it where it's like just all my videos and all my content, it's just a bunch of broken content. Just to overall see like that, that's overall what, yeah, I'm gonna do that. Just to see how people react to it. But I'm saying, people are gonna unsubscribe. They're gonna be like, this video is horrible. You got too many mistakes and stuff. So that's what I'm saying. It's like, fam, you got all those mistakes and you ain't trying to work on them, you need to close up shop. That's my best recommendation to companies out there that just don't care. So, but anyways, now wrestling's about to come on here in a moment. So thank you guys for watching and or listening. Stay tuned for the next stream. Stay tuned for the next podcast episode. And peace.